Hello, this is Joshua Hamlin, lead instructor at Sigma 3 Survival School. Welcome back to the Trapper's Bible. Today we're going to cover a very successful bird snare called the coat hanger bird snare. It's especially effective against doves, and we're going to go make one now, so come with us. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to locate is a V. Well, you don't need to locate one, you can lash one, but it's easy to locate, so we located one here. So I'm going to cut down this branch here. Well, this is why it's called a coat hanger, because it hangs like this. Now we're going to need a perch stick. Okay, so we got our V here. Now we need a perch. This stick I cut from the same tree. We'll just get rid of these branches. Okay, our perch needs to be from here to here. So we'll cut off this end here. Now how this is going to sit on here is we're going to make a split here and a split here and flatten the edges of this and then just slide this into the split so that it falls off easily as soon as weight's applied to it. All right, we're going to make our splits parallel at the ends of these sticks. We don't want to make our splits too deep or it'll be too sensitive and it'll just fall off every time the wind blows. Now we're going to take this stick and just flatten the ends, about like that, and then parallel to that on this side. Now these are going to fit into these slits just like that. Notice how easily it falls off. All right, our sticks fit right into the split on this stick. So when a bird flies and lands on it, boom, it falls off.
When placing your traps, you want to be very mindful of the locations you choose. You want to pay attention to the local habits of the birds. You know, where are their transition areas, where are their feeding areas, where are their shelter areas, and try to find spots where they congregate regularly. And then also pay attention to the bait sources that you can use to try to attract those birds to your snares, and that can be a range of things, but really the trick with this is just to pay attention to the local bird movements and what they like to eat.
All right, we're going to be suspending a snare from up here, but we need something to hold it open since we're using string. If you're using wire, you don't have to do this. So what we're going to do is just about halfway down is we're just going to make a little slit on each side that the string can sit on. Just about like that.
So when making your snare loop, it's very simple. You want to take and just do like an overhand knot, but leave your loop just a little bit large because we're going to do the poacher snare, which essentially your loop's just a little bit larger, and you're going to take and roll that over into a figure eight. Then connect the two loops together. Feed the end back through that. If you'll notice, because the cord is double wrapped on the snare, that when it tightens down, it doesn't want to release up. It's almost like a locking knot. That's going to ensure that you have greater success.
What I'm doing now is just tying the snare on here, hoping that I got it the right distance. And if not, I'm making a easy to untie knot here so I can adjust it. Open the snare, set one of the strings in the little slit that I cut there. Set the other side of the string in the little slit that I cut.
And now what I'm doing is just hanging this from a branch. Notice that this branch is next to a field where doves hang out. You can do this in the middle of a field. You can cut a long stick and stake it out there, and then you don't even need bait because they need something to land on. If they see something to land on, they will land on it. You can also set this up near your camp. Birds being curious will come just to check it out without bait. Of course, it's way more successful if you have bait. Now we're going to take our loop of our snare and stick it in these slits here to hold it open. Now when a bird flies, sees a piece of bait hanging from here, here's where you would hang your bait, or you could hang it from here, and it'll fly, land on this, their head will go through here when they land, the stick will fall off, they'll try to fly away, and the snare will wrap around their neck. Okay, so that's our coat hanger bird snare. This trap is very easy to make. We can make it in about 3 minutes, so you can set up 50, 100 of them, which you're going to need to do if you want to make a sustainable amount of food. You set this on transition areas in open fields, places where perch birds are likely to sit and roost and peck the ground and look for bait. We use things like berries for bait, something that's colorful. Birds are not colorblind, unlike most animals. They find food by color, so use something colorful, bright berries, grapes, buckbrush, something like that, and they will come. This is a very effective trap. It's the most effective bird trap that I know of, so that's why we're showing you this one first. Please continue to watch our other traps in the Survival Trappers Bible series. And thanks for supporting Sigma 3. Keep watching. Lots more good stuff to come. Thanks.